Hello everyone. In this semester, I am going to teach you organic chemistry. This semester, organic chemistry is divided into 6 chapters. In first chapter, we are going to study the strength of organic acids and bases. In second chapter, we will study the stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane. In third chapter, nucleophilic substitution at aliphatic carbon. In fourth chapter, reactions of unsaturated hydrocarbons and carbon oxygen double bond. In fifth chapter, we will study the elimination reactions. And in the sixth chapter, we will study the aromatic, electrophilic and nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now we will start our first chapter, the strength of organic acids and bases. What should we learn from this chapter? So at the end of this topic, you must know what is mean by acid and base, what is mean by strength of acids and bases, how strength is determined, what is mean by Ka and Kb, pK and pKb values, what are the factors responsible for change in acidity and basicity, what is mean by specific and general acid catalysis reaction and base catalysis reaction. So now we will start from the basic concepts of acids and bases. You know that there are three basic concepts. First is Arrhenius acid base concept. Second is Lorry-Bronsted acid base concept. And third is Lewis acid base concept. Now we will go to the first concept, Arrhenius acid base concept. According to this concept, acids are those compounds which gives the H plus ion in water. Example, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, etc. When hydrochloric acid is dissociated in water, then that get converted into H plus and Cl minus ion. According to definition of Arrhenius acid, the molecule which gives H plus ion is called acid. So that's why this HCl is acidic in nature. And when we consider the definition of base, then the molecule which gives the hydroxide ions in water is called base. Example, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, lithium hydroxide. When the sodium hydroxide is dissociated in water, then that get converted into Na plus and OH minus ion. When we apply the definition, then according to Arrhenius acid base concept, the acids are those compounds which gives the H plus ion, and the bases are those compounds which gives the hydroxide ion. Now come to the second concept, Lorry-Bronsted acid base concept. This concept is based on the proton donor and proton acceptor. So the acids are those compounds which can donate the H plus ion, and bases are those compounds which can accept the H plus ion. For example, ammonia and HCl when react, they get converted into ammonium ion and Cl minus ion. So here, when we apply the Lorry-Bronsted acid base concept, then ammonia molecule accept the proton and hydrochloric acid donate the proton. So with respect to that, ammonia is base and hydrochloric acid is acid. Come to the third concept, Lewis acid base concept, which is depend on the electron pair donor and electron pair acceptor. So the acids are those compounds which can accept the electron pair, and bases are those compounds they can donate the electron pair. Example, ammonia will react with borane and that get converted into the product. So now in this reaction, the ammonia molecule will have a one lone pair and the boron will have one empty orbital. So the boron is electron deficient and ammonia is electron rich. So the ammonia will donate its lone pair to the electron deficient boron, and they get converted into the product. So that means, according to Lewis acid base concept, ammonia donate the electron pair, that's why this is called Lewis base, and the boron will accept that lone pair, that's why that is called the Lewis acid. Now the next concept is the strength of an acid or strength of an base. So you know that the strength of acid is determined by the Ka and pKa value, and that Ka and pKa value is determined by the extent of dissociation of that acid as well as base water. And the extent of dissociation is determined by using the equilibrium constant. Now for example, the water when dissociated the Ha acid, then that get converted into the conjugate acid and conjugate base. By this equation, we can find out the equilibrium constant of this reaction. The equilibrium constant equation is Ka is equal to concentration of hydronium ion, the concentration of A minus, which is conjugate base, divided by concentration of acid. Here, we do not consider the concentration of water because water is act as a solvent and its concentration is very high. So then it doesn't have the much change in the reaction. So Ka is generally converted into pKa when we determine the strength of acid, because the Ka value is always come in the negative power of 10, so that to become convenient scale, this Ka is converted into pKa by using the equation pKa is equal to minus log K to the base 10. For example, acetic acid in water at 25 degree centigrade, the Ka value will be calculated from the equation. Now then, from this equation we will get the Ka value 1.79 into 10 raised to minus 5. When we put this value in the above equation, from that we will get the pKa value, which is 4.6. From this we conclude that for stronger acid the Ka value will become larger and pKa value become smaller, and for weaker acid Ka value becomes smaller and pKa value will become larger. In the same way, the strength of base is also determined again by using the reaction. The base when dissociated in water, then that get converted into conjugate acid and conjugate base. Therefore, we use the same equilibrium constant equation K, but here this is for base, that's why we will write KB, which is basicity constant, is equal to the concentration of conjugate acid into concentration of conjugate base divided by concentration of base. Here also we do not consider the water because water is also water act as a solvent and it is in excess. So here when we consider the strength of base, then you know that the strength of base is always given in the form of pKa. So it is not given in KB or pKb, because to avoid the different scale we will consider the single continuous scale for acids as well as bases. That's why acid as well as base is determined in the form of Ka and pKa, so that for this reaction we have to find out the Ka, and from the Ka we will find out pKa value. So we will consider the same reaction in a reversible form. The conjugate acid which is formed in last reaction is get dissociated in water again, and that get converted into hydronium ion and base. This equation we will use for the finding out the equilibrium constant Ka, so which is equal to the concentration of hydronium ion into the concentration of base divided by the concentration of conjugate acid. So from that we will get the K value, and from this K value we will determine the pKa value. So from that we may say Ka and pKa is the measure of acid strength of conjugate acid of the base. Stronger the conjugate acid, weaker will be the base, and the smaller the pKa for conjugate acid, weaker will be the base. In conclusion, so we have four different things we learn. Arrhenius theory, according to that acid gives proton and base gives hydroxide ion. According to Lauer-Bronsted theory, acid gives proton, base accepts proton. According to Lewis theory, acid accepts electron pair and base donates electron pair. And the strength of acid and bases are determined by pKa value. Smaller the pKa value, stronger the acid. Larger the pKa value, stronger is the base. Thank you.